days. He's yet in his sovereignty, allowing your money to run out, allowing all hell to break loose in your relationships. Not because God has cursed your life, but because he's trying to get you into heaven's delivery room. He's trying to announce to you that your problem is a divine announcement. Heaven is pregnant with your next breakthrough. Heaven is pregnant with your ministry. This is not the time for you to give up. This is the time for you to push. You've got to get on your knees. Ask God, give me the anointing of Elijah. The Bible said Elijah was a man, just like you and me. He had the same proclivities. He had the same hang-ups. He had the same habits. But when it came time to pray, he often prayed. Hallelujah, in spite of the negative circumstances. Israel, glory to God, was in the throes of a great economic crisis. Israel's enemies were guilty of terrorism. The Bible said in the book of Judges, chapter number 6, that in the midst of impoverishment, in the midst of an economic crisis, in the midst of economic recession, children of Israel cried to the Lord because of the Midians, and the Lord sent the prophet. God is sending a prophetic word. I wish I could stay here and talk to you about what God is going to be doing prophetically, but the time is late, so we're going to rush on past that point. The Bible said when they prayed, they activated a prophetic round. They activated a prophetic anointing. We've got to learn how to pray until we recalibrate these spheres in our churches, until the atmosphere and environment can support the prophetic anointing. I'm not talking about just prophets rising up saying, "Thus saith the Lord," but I'm talking about a new kind of anointing that is about to come upon the team. God is going to release you like you released John the Revelator. We're going to find your spot on your own prophetic hour. God is driving people away from you, not because he wants you to be lonely, but because he wants to shift things in your life and give you a panoramic view of the things to come in your life. He wants to show you what he had in mind for you. Many people believe they know what God is going to do in your life, but God is getting ready to blow their mind. God is going to do that process. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of men. The things that God has prepared for them, heaven is pregnant, and heaven is getting ready to deliver. The Bible said, as soon as Israel cried out, it activated a prophetic dimension in the realm of the Spirit, and God broke out an undeveloped general by the name of Gideon. Gideon didn't have it all together. The Bible said the angel of the Lord found him threshing wheat at the wine press. I wish I could stop and preach this. When God gets through to you, you're going to be doing the unorthodox. You're going to be doing the unexpected. You're not going to be acquiescent to no denominational expectation of what God should be doing in your life. God is about to make you an example. He's about to take your ministry, your life, and business in an unexpected way, in an unorthodox way. God is going to bring you from out of obscurity. You no longer going to be controlled by your environment. Gideon, before he had an encounter with God, before the intercessors prayed him from out of obscurity into a place of prominence, glory to God, he was a victim of his environment. But God has a way of the overriding. Hallelujah, the greatest of background. I love God. He masters. Hallelujah, he majors.